Hello guys, welcome back to a new 7 Nights 2 gameplay guide. In this video guys, I'm gonna talk about on how to increase your account power as fast as possible, which are those ways, the free to play also ways, because not everybody can spend money. So let's see, right now I have 295,000 and I'm very close to 300,000, where I'm gonna get Rachel, legendary Rachel, which will be a nice addition to my team. And then guys, you start getting also legendary, free legendary gear. So this is a good reason, so a very good reason why you want to increase your combat power for your account is for all the free heroes that you're getting free gear, gold, as you can see, 1.5 million, accessories, legendary gear and so on, even Topaz, which is very good, maps and so on. So, and the final one will be Shane guys, but will be a long way. But let's see guys, how you can do that faster, which are the ways to increase your combat power. Also you need combat power for everything, no? Combat power, it's the most important thing. Okay, so let's see which are those ways. So one of the ways guys is getting more heroes. So the more heroes you have, the better. Why? You're gonna see why. So I have 31 out of 47. So try to get as many heroes as possible. Each hero has a specific, has combat power, no? So how you calculate the account combat power? You add the power from all these heroes. So it doesn't matter if even the common ones. Even on this one, see, I have 4,900. So get as many heroes as possible, guys. That's the first thing, no? So to whatever ways you have, okay, with gems, from events, from raising the account combat power. So try to get as many. Another way, get a decent pet, okay? Me, right now, I have right here some really cool pets. This I got, you can get them from summon tickets, you get from events free summon tickets guys. So let's see which one should I use. Block efficiency, let's change to this one. So get better pets. Also another way you can get your first rare pet, okay, is from the general shop. So from general shop Topaz, 3,000 for one guarantee rare to legendary pet. So rare, at least rare. You can, if you're lucky, maybe you get legendary. But at least rare you'll get, okay? So get a pet. Pet can give you a rare one, 7,500 CP for your team. Okay, next. Then we're gonna go back to heroes because there are many things. Another way, guys, increase the divinity, okay, divinity level. Try to get attack, for example, gives a nice boost, defense also, but try to get them all. After you reach a specific level, the chance of success starts to drop. For example, here I managed to, after level 4 I think, you get to next level where you consume different types of runes, okay? So for, to get, how you can get these runes guys, and by the way, this, okay, these ones, and I'm gonna try, let's see if I can get, let's try to get the attack higher. So it's not guaranteed guys, but if you succeed, oh nice, see, let's see, 1339 just from one level guys. So the higher the level, the more CP. This is CP for your entire account, so all characters will benefit from these stats, okay? So this is really cool. Let's try to get one more. Can I get it? Okay, wish me, attack is very important. Okay, just failed, come on, nice. Let's see how much this time, 1620. And yeah, so this, the runes, you can get them guys, these runes. Okay, let's try to get one more for 300. Attack, success, nice, 2144. So how you can get these runes guys? From farming the dungeons. You have rune dungeons. Do, so very important to increase your CP, do all the dungeons. You need gold now to enhance everything. You need soul stones to increase the level cap of your characters after level 30, you know? So farm soul stones, farm elixirs. Okay, these ones, you're gonna see, you need them also to increase the CP individual for each individual character. Runes, you saw, I just used them. And try, guys, and also experience to level up your characters. So, runes. So, the higher you go, guys, try to get to higher tier. Why? You get more and more, better and better rewards. Another thing, buy the extra entries for all these dungeons. Where? Well, get to the shop every day, guys. You can buy... Okay, I'm gonna show you friendship points. For friendship points, you can get for see rune experience entries, the rune temple, elixir temple, soul stones, gold. So buy every day with friendship points. So add friends as many. Also from the arena, let me see. Ah, you can get, by the way, in here you can get gear. So I'm gonna talk about gear also. So try to buy the stuff, free stuff from all this shop. Topaz also very useful to get. See, you can get runes. So let me get some extra. Should I buy this one? So yeah, this one. Runes and elixirs. So elixirs, okay, because I showed you how you can get the elixirs from the dungeon and from the shop every day. So potential, where you use elixir. So once you get legendaries and very good rare characters, try to enhance their stats like attack, defense and HP. The higher the better, okay? The higher the stats, the better, see? So farm these elixirs from the dungeons. You can get extra entries, I just showed you, every day. Get to higher difficulty levels. And also, so yeah, I forgot what else I wanted to say. So farm those things, okay, that you need to get them. And this you can do, I recommend to do for the characters that are good. So don't waste on other lower tier characters like this ones. It's not really worth it, because these are only per character. So they don't benefit, not the entire account benefits, only that character, okay? So this is another way to increase your CP. Let's see what else we have. Mastery. Okay, mastery. You need rubies or crystals, however you want to call. Here you can unlock more accessories, see, accessory slots, and you can increase the damage, defense and other crit rate for your characters. I'm gonna increase the crit rate. Boom, 350, see? And this is account base, so on your entire account. So use the rubies in here to unlock secret damage. So you choose what you want, okay, which path you want to go. So these are quite important, okay? These, all the characters benefit from this, sorry. Save, okay. Another thing, you have codex, okay? Codex in here, guys. The more characters you get these buffs. You can see my total buffs. See, defense, HP, attack, okay? So the more characters you unlock, you get all these buffs. You can see in here. Let's see. So also, depending on their level, proficiency and skill level and so on, you get even more buffs from here, from the codex. Same for the equipment, pets and outfits. You get buffs, see, total buffs from here. So try to get more stuff now to unlock in codex. For those buffs are for the entire account, by the way, from the codex. Next thing, guys, let's see, we talked about pets. Okay, now let's go back to heroes. Definitely getting legendary heroes will be better, because legendary and legendary plus heroes, they have better stats. They give you overall more CP and they are better, okay? But even the other grades are good. Why? For example, once, let's say, for legendary, it's very hard, guys, to level them up, okay? You need to transcend them, like this one, see? So I can transcend, I have the soul stones. The higher the level, the more soul stones. And to unlock higher levels, okay? So I recommend, if you have some rare, like this one, see? I have 20 soul stones, so use those Even if you if they are not legendary, if they are good like this one, okay, try to unlock the levels to get to level 40 or higher, okay, because on for rares it is easier to get the soul stones. And levels, as you know, higher levels will give you what, more CP for each character, no? So let's level up this one so you see what I'm talking about. And let's get her to 35. So you need experience potions. Other way to get experience, I'm gonna show you, see? And you increase the power, plus each 5 levels, what else you increase? The you can level up the skills, so that's another way to further advance your characters. The power, 50 power for each level, so each time you enhance is 250 power from each character. And you can do this on the characters. I recommend the levels, don't level up on the characters that you don't in the skill levels, don't level up on the characters that you don't intend to use, okay? Only on the ones, because it's very costly. Gold you'll need, you'll see, you'll burn very fast the gold, so spend wisely the gold, very important. Also, leveling up all the characters, even this one, guys. A good way, if you don't want to waste, and I don't recommend to waste the XP potions, is doing field exploration. It's one way. You can change the gear from your strongest characters to the weaker ones and get to level 20. Very easy to get to level 20, 25. If you do explore, if you don't have maps, actually a very even better way that doesn't cost you anything, just time, is farming AFK. I did a video on that. There are some areas in the, okay, in the, you can repeat, okay, you can repeat all the chapters from the story, and there are some areas where you find monsters that keep on respawning. Go and check that video, the video how to farm infinite experience, gold, and materials like gear, okay? So you'll see what I'm talking about. So you can do that. That's actually a very good way. You can leave it overnight or during the day, doesn't matter, on your computer or even on your phone. They will farm non-stop and they will level up. You'll get gear, and the gear you can extract, okay? So the gear, you can get gold, salvage, not extract. Can get gold and enhancement materials, because gear, it's very important also to enhance your characters. No, the higher the grade, the better. So try to get better gear. How you can get better gear? Do dungeons, do the story, do the events, and craft. Don't forget about crafting, guys. You can craft, see, and actually I'm gonna craft, you can craft even legendary gear. I'm getting closer to craft some legendary gear. Also, gear you can get from this everyday, check the this shop for gold and or rubies. I got one of my legendary gear from here for 1 million gold. That's why gold is very important. Get the maps, the free ones, okay? Get the enhancement materials. Get the good gear if you don't have, okay? You can get rare, even legendary. I got legendary. If you don't believe me, I have 3 legendaries, see? One from, two from the pools, and one from the that shop, okay, for gold. So the higher the grade of the legendary, the better. Another thing, when you equip on your character, try to complete sets. So don't put them randomly. Why? You get more, like, give for tank, defense, or block rate. You can have two. To activate one set buff, you need at least 2, okay? So you can combine like 2 sets block rate and 3 defense for tank, no? For attack, you can combine full attack, like here, as you can see, full attack. Or you can go 2 for attack and 3 for crit rate. Or 3 for attack and 2 for crit rate. So you can mix them like that, guys. So try to equip sets on every character, even on the lowest tier. You'll see. I'll try to complete sets, see? So don't put them randomly. Why? Because you get more CP if you have the more pieces of the same set. Another thing that you want to do, enhance. Okay, try to enhance the gear. So let me see. So that's why you need enhancement materials, and that's why it's good to farm, no? So let me, equipment. So enhance your gear, okay? Enhance it at least. You know, the weapon, it's very important for attack, extra attack, try to enhance it. And also transcend the gear. In order to transcend, you need the same type. Boom. Transcendence also, I don't recommend if you're low on gold, but it's another way, just so you know, okay? So getting higher quality gear, enhance it and transcend, and also equipping sets. That's another great way to increase your combat power, okay? What else? I talked about leveling up all the characters, the skills for the ones that you're using. Let's see, did I forget anything? Pets, I talked about that, no? So crafting, and definitely doing all the daily things, okay? Farm AFK using the method that I talked about in a previous video. So that's, I think these are the most important things. Now let's see if I got, yeah, so there you go guys. I have 303,000 and I could increase even more. But I recommend don't waste the experience potion, the gold, the runes, or how they are called, not runes, elixirs, because the runes are for the entire account, elixirs on characters that you don't intend to use, okay, very important. Okay, let's get her, and now guess what, my CP will go even higher. Let me give you a taste of Agni's true power. I can level her up, I can equip gear on her, and so on, and then I will be able to get legendary and so on. So this is very important thing. These are very important things, okay? I am completely free to play, and I didn't play that much, like few hours per day. If I was to focus on this game, I believe I will be around maybe 500,000 at least combat power, or somewhere around there. So yeah, it's not that hard guys. Also don't forget about PvP rubies. It's a great way to get legendary heroes, gear, pets, okay? So farm rubies in the arena, and there are other ways, okay? So, and complete events. Events can give you also free stuff. So check every time what events. You can check in my previous video how I got lots of summon tickets, and what I got legendary gear and heroes from the summons, so you can do that also. So yeah, these are the main ways. Let me know what's your current account combat power. Soon I'm gonna get to 400,000. So yeah, let me know guys, and see you soon. Bye.